Hey everybody, Janine here. I know this is a very different setting today than normal, but I'm actually sitting in my lounge room so that I can be in front of the computer and show you how this is done. So just be aware that things are going to sound different, look different. You may hear birds or the crazy cat, who knows? So today I'm going to show you how I create personalized round editable images. I'm going to show you how to do this in two different programs. The first program I'm going to show you how to make one in is in Photoshop. And for those of you that don't have Photoshop, I'm then going to show you how to create a simple version in Microsoft Publisher. So, no time to waste, let's get on with it. So the first thing I do, of course, when I'm working in Photoshop is I open Photoshop. You want to go to Create New, and I already have up here an A4 size, so Create. And I now have my A4 size piece of paper. And because I'm using A4 editable image paper, this is going to be perfect. Okay, so the next thing I need to do is make a circle, and I need to make it the size of the cake that I'm using it for. So I go down here to my ellipse tool, click on that, and up here it's got the width and the height. Now, right click to make sure that you are in inches or centimeters, whatever you're working in. Of course, I'm working in inches, and then in width, put whatever size round you need. I need 7. I then click on my page, and this will tell me that it's a 7-inch wide and a 7-inch high ellipse that we're creating. Okie dokie. And there she is. Okay, me being a little bit OCD, I'm just gonna pop her in the center. Ta-da! Okay, so the next thing I want to do is actually change the pattern that's inside here. I want a yellow polka dot pattern. So what I have to do now is go up into File and go Place Embedded. And I've actually made this file with some photos and pictures that I want in this image. Now make sure that any pictures that you're going to put over the top of the background all have transparent backgrounds or it will not work. Here is my image that I want to use for my background, so I click on that and press place. Now, as you can see, it's not exactly the right size. It doesn't fit the whole circle area, so I'm going to press shift, and then with the corner, just pull it upwards. By pressing shift, everything stays the right size. Once again, OCD, and I'm placing it in the center. And that's done. But of course, it's not a circle and we need to make it a circle. So I'm going down here to my ellipse layer and I'm just going to move it up above the background layer. Okay. Now we don't want to see this pink. So the next thing I need to do is I'm going back to my ellipse layer here and I'm going to right click and I'm going to go up here and press convert to frame. Ta-da! We now have a circle filled with the background. So the next thing I want to do is start adding some pictures in here to personalize the editable image. So the first thing we're going to do is go up here to File. Then I'm going to go back down to Place Embedded like I did with the background. And once again, I have these pictures. Like I said, all of them have transparent backgrounds. So, and make sure that they are all royalty-free stock images. Clicked on my little koala and press place. And I forgot to press my shift key to make sure that he stays the right size. But there we go. Once he's in place, we can change where he is later, but once it's in place, we are done. Okay. What I find easiest is just clicking on the gray here to make sure that I'm not using any other layer before I add another picture. I want to put a party hat on him, so I'm going back to Place Embedded. I have a party hat here, and I'm clicking Shift this time to keep my shape uniform. Taking it right down in size and pop that on his head. There we go. And the last picture I'm putting in are some pink balloons. So once again, my Shift key and sizing them down because they're a bit big. And I want them to go behind him, but as you can see, probably, they're actually in front of his, oops, They're actually in front of his ear because this layer is above the other layer. So all I have to do is move that layer down. Not that layer, that's the koala. Click on the right layer first. Move that down past the party hat and past the koala. That will make sure that those strings from the balloon are now behind his ear. That part's done. Now I want to add a little bit of personalized text. So here we go. I'm going to go over here to my text tool and I'm going to click it around about where I want the text. Up here, of course, you can change the text that you're using, the sizes, etc., etc. I've got everything set the right way, the colors. And then I'm going to type my message in. Lara is one. That's the message. Now I want this to arch over this way. So to do that, what I have to do is go up here to this little tool here, and in style, I'm going to click the arrow down and press arc. Now, as you can see here, it's plus 50%. We're still going to need that a little bit later. Press OK, and now it is arched. Of course, you can change that to whatever arch you want. And I am moving it into the center, about there. Okay? And I want another message down the bottom here. So I'm just going to once again press my text tool and write, it's party time. Once again, I'm going to arch it, but this time we're not going plus 50 because we want it to go up the other way. So all we have to do to change that is put a minus in. Press OK and it is done. Once again, I'm going to center it. And there we have the personalized message. I want an outline on these, so I'm going to go down here and I'm going to double click that. And then I'm going to actually right click on here, go to blending options. And in blending options, you will find an option called stroke. Just tick that. And it is done. A cute little outline on that just to make it a little more bold. Doing the same over here, blending options and stroke and okay. Now, if you want to change the color of the stroke on the outside, just go down to the layer that it's on, say it's party time, and then click the stroke down here. And just here, you can change it to any color you wish. But I'm happy with what I have. So the last thing I want to do on this image is, as you can see here, it's a little bit difficult to see where we have to cut, and that's going to be an issue. I want to make a cutting line so that makes that job super, super simple. So once again, I come back down to my ellipse tool and I make sure that it is a 7 by 7 and pop it in there. Okay. Of course, here we have a problem because that is colored. We don't want it colored. So I'm going to go here and now there's no color. Okay. Now, the other thing I want to do is add a stroke to this. So blending options, once again, just makes it easier. I know you can do it in the other screen, but I find this a lot easier. And now it actually has a color around it. I just want to move that to the center because I know the other one is centered. And boom, we have the cutting line around the outside. Now, of course, this isn't exactly perfect. It's not how I'd want it. I'll move him down a little bit, but of course I can do all of that afterwards. Then all you have to do is go into print and voila, it's ready to go. The other great thing about this is if you've used, say, a part of your icing sheet already and you want to utilize the rest of it, from right here, you can move the image to where you want to move it. And that's how you create a personalized circular edible image in Photoshop. Well, that's how I do it anyway. Okay, now I'm gonna take you over to Microsoft Publisher for those of you that don't have Photoshop, and I'll show you how to quickly make it in that program. Okay, so I've opened up Publisher and I have an A4 sheet right in front of me. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is, just like in Photoshop, create the circle. So, Up here, I'm going to put insert, go down to shapes, and go down to this little circle number. With the left button down, just click and drag. Now this doesn't have to be perfect because we're going to resize it. Put it around about center, and then I'm going to right click and go to format auto shape. Now for fill effects, we're going to change the fill effects. We're going to go to picture or texture fill, picture source, insert, from a file, and I'm going to go back to that little file that I had and pick my background, insert. Now we need to go down here and put lock aspect ratio, otherwise it's going to turn out a little bit skewed. So this makes sure that our polka dots stay nice and round and polka dotty. Press OK. The other thing we want to do is whatever color cutting line you want, that's what this line color has to be, okay? Go to size. Now this is in centimeters, so I'm going to change this. 17.78 centimeters actually equals 7 inches. So that's what I'm doing. I'm pressing OK. And there we have our circle filled with our yellow polka dots. Voila. Okay, and our cutting line all ready to go. Now I'm going to insert my pictures exactly the same way. Once again, press the shift, it works the same here, and move him up into place. Okay, very quickly do this. That's way too big. Leave that there. And last but not least, the balloons, which are once again far too big. And once again, that string comes over the ear. So in this program, all you need to do is right click and these little things here, bring forward, send backwards. I'm sending it backwards twice. And now the balloons are behind him. To add the text in here, the easiest way to do this I have found is insert word art and go for an art shape. Type in your text. Of course, choosing what font and size you want here, although the size will probably change. And I'm gonna pop that right there. And then I'm going to change the shape to curve that way. Then the next thing I want to do is format word art, fill effects. I want it as a solid fill here, okay? And the color I want is a cute little, it's a bit more purple, soft pink. There we go. Okay. Now the line, if you wanted that stroke, you just go to line here and then you can choose your color. I'll go with that color. Okay. So that's our inside, that's our outside, and press okay. And there it is. And you can change this. You can go up further, down further, out further. So you can play around with this. So I'm just going to pop that there, which is centered, and leave it there. Okay. And then of course, the same thing for the bottom section. I'm using the same thing. So that's the way we do it in Publisher. Once again, just press on file, print, and she's ready to go. Okay guys, so there you go. That's how I easily create my own personalized round editable images in both Photoshop and in Publisher. I hope this gave you a little bit of an insight. If you've got any questions, please don't hesitate to ask in the comment section below. Thank you so much for keeping me company. I hope that you like this video, and if you did, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so that you're informed every time I upload a new video. Well guys, I've got my image all ready and prepared to go. I'm gonna go and print it, and I'm gonna go and get my cake on. I suggest you do the same. I'll see you next time. Bye.